So now we will discuss about the buttons in Bootstrap. Whenever we want to define a buttons in the pages, web pages, it may be a forum like submit button, or it may be a input button, anything. So here we have different sizes. So large, normal, small, and extra small. So these sizes can be applied by using the classes ALG, SM, XS. So there are four button sizes are provided in Bootstrap. So with the, here only blue color is provided. We can change the color also by using button classes. So here we have different color examples for the buttons. So if we use primary, it comes as a blue button. Info, sky blue. Success, green. Warning, so some yellow color. Danger, red. Inverse, so light gray or black. So this is about the button color examples. So whenever we are using the button tag, so if we use this class, if we use the class button primary, we can get the blue color. If we use button info, we get this. So like this, we have different classes color for the buttons. So just if you use BTN button class, so it provides standard gray button with gradient. So like this, we have so different just for the visual effects. So now we will discuss with the examples. So different sizes of buttons and how we can define the buttons in web pages. So now we go with this button examples. So here we can observe. So four sizes: large, normal, small, and extra small. So to define that buttons in our web pages, so just use the button tag. So button tag is provided. So and here you can observe the class. So I am using the primary. Suppose if you want a different color, so we can use it. So I am using primary. Suppose if you want a warning color, so we can apply this. So now primary comes with blue, and if you want to make it as a warning button, so just change the class so to warning. So save it. So refresh. So now this normal becomes warning. Similar way, so here we have different classes. Suppose if you want a danger button, so just add the danger here. So I just use the danger class, DNGR. So save it. So automatically, so this button will become danger. That is, danger will reflect the red color. So like this. So without writing, I am not writing any CSS for changing the colors. So for providing the size. So if we are not using Bootstrap in our web pages, for every button, you have to define a CSS. So you have to set the height, you have to set the width, you have to set the background color, you have to set the border. So all those elements you have to write it for each and every button. So just to avoid that, so just I can use this class in my button tag. So and I can get the effects. So large, this is the large. And so by default, the buttons will be normal. This is the normal by default. If we are not specifying large, small, or extra small, so just by default, it takes normal. So again, if you want small, so you have to add this button SM. So if you want extra small, you have to add this button XS. So if we remove this, so by default, it takes the normal class. So this is regarding buttons. So where we can define different size buttons on our web pages. And also we can provide the CSS, so by using the classes. So there are 5 to 6 classes that are provided for the buttons. So we can use these classes in our buttons to make the buttons effective. So this is regarding button sizes. There are 4 sizes. So and we have different classes per color of the buttons. So next example. So block buttons. So if you want buttons in a very big width, so we can go for this block level buttons. So that is example 2. So here I am using this class and I am making this block. So block will make this button to appear to the 100% width of the screen. So again, I can use the sizes. So this is large, this is normal, and this is small. So here, large button, small button. So by default, it is normal button. So we can define the block buttons. So that appears, that adjusts to the width of the screen. So that is regarding this block buttons. So whenever you want to define a block buttons, so in the button tag, so we have, this is the code for adding the buttons. So in the button tag, we have to mention this class. So button primary, so and again button block. So everywhere I used primary, so it appears blue. So now if you want to change the class, so you can change it. So here, suppose let's say I make it info class. So now you can observe the changes. So it provides a light blue. So similar way, if you want danger, that is red color, so we can use the danger class. So automatically it will change. So without writing any CSS colors, so we can make our web pages look colorful. So that is by using this block. So if we want block buttons, so just you have to add this button block in your class. So this is the overall class, predefined class. So where we can achieve this. So here you can observe there are 2 buttons. So light gray. So whenever I move the cursor on this button 2, so it appears so light gray, that is H over class. That is by default. If we are not mentioning any primary classes, so we have one default class also. So that default class will provide us this light gray. So light gray is provided. So if you don't want that light gray, we can change it. We can change it to warning. We can change this warning. So here you can observe the changes. So in Bootstrap, so just by using the classes, so we can make our web pages look colorful. So just we have to define classes in the particular tags. So which class has to be defined in which tag? So that we have to understand. So if we learn that, so then automatically we can define very colorful web pages. So this is regarding the button second example. So that is block buttons. So that will expand up to the width of the screen, 100% width. So next we'll see the third example in the button. So there are three types of buttons. So here we can observe this. So this is highlighted, that is the active button. So and this is light normal, and this is disabled button. So if it is disabled, if we move the cursor on that button, so it appears red. So this is all the CSS are defined in the Bootstrap. Say for example, we provided some links in the web pages. So and we want to disable that link for some time. So then we can disable that link. Say for example, application. So click here to fill the application form. So if the time period expires, so that application link for the application, we can disable it. So that is by using this example. So here we can make it as a three. One is by default, it considers lightly. And next is active class. So if we make it active, it looks brighter. So and if we make it disabled, so it looks dull. And if we move the cursor, this link will not work. So this activities can be included in our web pages. So whenever the time period expires, we can disable the links. We can disable the links. So after some particular time period, so that user will not get access to this applications. So we in Bootstrap, we have this class called disabled. So we can use that to disable the links. So this is about three types: active, normal, and disabled buttons. So if suppose we are publishing the events, so the recently uploaded events or recently uploaded links, we can make it as active, so that this will be highlighted over the previous links. Suppose here we have some previous links. So and if we want to highlight today what we uploaded on the web page link, so that we can make that bold or we can make that brighter by using the active class. So this is how for the important links on the web pages, we can make it as active. So active, it will be highlighted compared to the other buttons. And we can also disable the button link. So disabled buttons works like this. It will not provide us to click on that button. This is about this three types of buttons. So what we can use in our Bootstrap exam. This code is same. This head tag, just copy this head code in your web pages, so that all the Bootstrap will be linked to your web pages. Next, we can use the classes. So all these classes can be used. So next example we'll discuss. So this is about this button group. So if we want to group the buttons, so that is also available. So we can group the buttons instead of separating it. So Apple, Samsung, Sony. So we can group this buttons. So for that, so we have one class called button group. So in this division section, so we are using the class button group. So as many as you buttons you want, you can link it here. Suppose you want to add two more buttons in the same link, so we can add this. So here CI tech, and here we can provide MCA. So like this, we can create a group of buttons. So the buttons will be added. Again, if you want to add, like, so just provide this and JIT. So now say for example, ohm. So about contact again student again admission. So just save this. So here you can see. So about contact student admission. So like this, wherever suppose here user clicks, just give an H reference link. So automatically it will take to the about page. So like this, we can add a group of buttons. So if user wants to know the admission status, so just click on admission, it will go to the admission page. So there we have to provide the, so here in this, we have to provide this H reference links. So this is about this button groups. So we can link the buttons. So there is a group of buttons can be created by using this division class button group. So whichever the buttons you want, we can keep on adding this and we can give the hreference link. So once user clicks this, it has to go to that particular page. That is about this group of buttons. So next example we discuss is, so that is horizontal, and if you want a vertical button group, so if you want vertical button group, we can add this. So similar way like what we discussed here. So here we added this horizontally, and now if you want vertically, so this is the class vertical. So now just I had here, so home about page everything. So now here you observe, so it appears vertically. So home about contact student admissions. So like this, we can provide the vertical buttons as well as horizontal buttons can be provided. So for that, we have to use this class, one division class. Inside the division class, we have to add this class button group vertical. So you can list all the buttons, whatever you want, that appears in this way. So it appears on the web page. So here you can provide the links for each page. So this is about this button group vertical. So and button group horizontal. By default, it is horizontal. So if you want to make it vertical, so you have to add this vertical class. So this is about this button groups. So the button groups are linked, attached to each other. So it looks good whenever we want to provide links at the side of the page. Next example regarding buttons. So here, whenever we are defining a buttons, we can also use this select option. So just like a navigation select, so tablet, smartphone, so whatever we want, we can list under that particular button. So now here you can see this code, example 5. So example 6. Yes, so here we are using this class button group. So and again inside that button group, we are creating two buttons, Apple and Samsung. So after that, I am creating one more button group. So under that, I am providing Sony tablet smartphone. Say for example, now you want to provide the departments. So just use this departments. Departments. So here you can provide this departments. So MCA. So MBA. So like this, we can list the buttons. So again, add this. So here, CSE, ISE, MEC, and Civil. So I'm not providing any links here. So just I use this. So if you want to provide a link for this page, so just use this hreference under this A tag. So here we can provide this MCA page link. Save this. So now if I refresh here, so it comes departments. So if I click departments, it comes MCA, MBA, CSE, ISE, MEC, Civil. So everything will be displayed. So this is regarding this Bootstrap buttons. So here we can provide this list under a particular button. So here I used this primary, so it is appearing blue. So we can change that. Danger, warning, anything you can change. So if you want to give this this list under a particular button, so here, so you have to use this data toggle class, that is drop down. So again, so you have to use this departments. So and you can go on listing this drop down menu. So drop down menu can be provided under the buttons. So once we do that, so easily we can provide the buttons. So user, whichever he wants, he can go to CSC, he can go to MCA, anywhere. So here, if we provide the link, mca.html page, so automatically once user clicks here, automatically it goes to this particular page. So this is about the buttons and also providing the list. So for providing the drop-down menu for the buttons, so we have to add few classes, that is drop-down toggle, and set that drop-down toggle to drop-down. So and again, go on listing this list, unordered list, and list all the elements. So like this, we can provide the drop-down menus for buttons. So here we are providing only for departments. So a similar way we can provide for all the buttons. So this section is for adding this drop down buttons. So this is regarding the buttons. So under this buttons, so we discussed so many examples like how to provide this a drop-down menu for the buttons and a group of buttons and making the vertical group as well as the horizontal group and button sizes, so all those things.